Hi guys, and welcome back to Brain Friendly Thinking. One of the challenges when learning a new topic is we don't know yet how everything fits together. CaGas can help with working out these relationships. CaGas are graphical elements or diagrams that help us to explore the essentials of a concept or a topic, or how different components of that topic fit together. I talked about CaGas before on this channel, however, I haven't yet given them the exposure they deserve. CaGas can be used in many different ways to clarify or deepen your thinking. And today I would like to give you a few concrete examples of how I used CaGas when I started my PhD. My PhD is in neuroscience. But I'm an engineer and I worked for almost 5 years in the automotive industry before taking a left for my PhD. Even though I had a little bit of background in biology, there were many terms, concepts, and interrelations that were completely new to me. So I had to familiarize myself with this new material quickly, especially because as part of the application process, I already had to submit a 1,000-word research proposal. To do this, I did my ABC actives and categorization that I usually do and that I have talked a lot about on this channel before, but I also and crucially utilized CaGas quite extensively. And it was especially the CaGas that helped me to consolidate the new knowledge and to see interrelations that then would lead me to my research questions and to my research proposal. One of the problems I was facing was that there are just so many interconnected parts in the signaling pathway, and at the beginning one of the main challenges was just to keep the overview of who's doing what when. And so these were some of the first CaGas I created. Here you can see a very abstract CaGa that represents my understanding of the signaling pathway at that point. We start from the receptors in the hands, which I called hand sensors here, and from there the signal is transferred into an area in the brain which is called Brodmann Area 3B and another one which is called Brodmann Area 1. They are all part of what is known as the primary somatosensory cortex, or S1, and I indicated that by a dashed line. And from there they go to an area that is called secondary somatosensory cortex, or S2. And you can see that this area seems to combine the information of whatever it is that 3B and 1 have done. And from there it goes to another area called PV, and then another area called primary motor cortex, or M1. But I didn't really know what the connection was, so I did not draw any arrows. But from there it then goes to the hand motors. Here's another view of the same pathway with my understanding a little bit later on. You again see area 3B, you can see S2, and you see M1 again, and so on. So in a way it is similar to what I had drawn before, just in much more details. And it shows my growing understanding of the subject matter. It is very messy, you might not understand it, but as long as you use these CaGas for learning, the only thing that matters is that they make sense to yourself. They are tools to help you to understand and to help you think through the topic. Here's another type of CaGa which I use to organize and sharpen my understanding. This time it's not about physical or anatomical relationships. This time it's about how does recovery progress over time. For people who are injured before the age of 10, usually they regain full sensibility again, whereas adult people usually do not. But at the beginning, both young people and adult people are remarkably similar. At the beginning, we have the nerve cut and repair. That's represented by the first X in each case. Then after some time, people regain their sense for pain. That is called protective sensibility, and it's represented by the second X. But then something changes. Most young people or children go on to regain their full sensibility, and that means they can then use their hands in a normal way. But most adult people do not. So I drew 2X in the third line of adult people. One, regain full sensibility. The second, do not regain full sensibility. And that makes it much easier to think about our research question. What causes the divergence in recovery after the sense of pain has been restored? And finally, a little CaGa that summarizes the purpose of our research. The little blob on the left side represents the hand. The strange squiggle on the right side represents the brain. The lines between those two are the nerves that connect the receptors in the hands to the brain. After nerve injury and repair, one line of research focuses on How can we get the nerve fibers to regrow faster and better? And then the second one is, there is something happening in the brain that prevents full recovery. If we understand these changes better, we can potentially direct them to increase the speed of recovery and the quality of life of nerve injury patients. And this is really the long-term goal of our research.
So these CaGas and others like it really helped me to build my mental models and to zoom in and zoom out as I was focusing on different aspects and as I was learning new things about the topic. Very often you already have a partial understanding, but you can't quite put it into words. And drawing diagrams can actually be easier. By drawing CaGas, you focus on the essential bits, which as a consequence get strengthened. And once you got the essentials in place, it becomes much easier to hook on new information to those. Also, you see areas where things are not yet quite clear, or where after you draw it or as you draw it, you notice that is not quite right, or maybe I've got a question there. And that gives you more opportunity to think about the topic and to then go and see how can I close these gaps, how can I close these questions, read more stuff and so on. So drawing CaGas gave me the opportunity to think about the topic from a second angle. And by combining the first and the second angle together, that really gave me the edge in familiarizing myself quickly with the topic. It also gave me an opportunity, an extra opportunity, to take what I already know about engineering to help me to understand neuroscience better. Of course, not everything in a few months. However, I managed to build a solid foundation upon which I could then build throughout my PhD. If you want to improve the depth of your thinking, to learn better, to solve challenging problems, or to bring your ideas to life, you might be interested to know that I offer one-on-one coaching. If you're interested, you find my email address down in the description box. But if that sounds too expensive to you, or you really prefer to learn in a group, I'm also planning to offer cohort courses. If you're interested in that, there is a link down in the description box where you can register your interest. CaGas can be a great tool to work with ideas that are not yet clear enough in your mind to put into words. If you struggle with putting things into words, you might be interested in watching the video right here. Or if you want to learn more brain-friendly thinking techniques, you can watch the playlist right here. If you found the video useful, please don't forget to give the like button a high five. Consider subscribing if you haven't already. And until next time, keep thinking.